Jessie Nesper from the Rose Melnick Medical Museum at Youngstown State University. Today we're taking an in-depth look at the iron lung. Let me get out of here so I can show you around. Iron lungs usually refer to respirators that encase your entire body. They can be used in any kind of illness that impairs your breathing, such as paralysis of the diaphragm or severe cases of polio. They work by varying the air pressure inside the chamber. When the pressure becomes less than that inside your lungs, you inhale and air expands to fill your lungs. When the pressure is more than that inside your lungs, you exhale. Devices similar to the iron lung have been around since the 1830s. Philip Drinker and Dr. Lewis Shaw were the first to use the term iron lung to describe their machine in 1928. It was used widely in the polio epidemic that year. John Emerson, who ran a medical machine shop nearby, also saw their model. He made some improvements, including ports on the side where nurses could access the patient for care, and a bed that slid in and out. His first machine is now part of the Smithsonian Institution at the National Museum of American History. During the polio epidemics of the 1940s and 50s, American hospitals had wards full of polio patients and iron lungs. So let's turn this thing on. The switch for the motor is on the front, along with a switch for the light inside the chamber. At the bottom is a knob that controls the respiration rate of the machine. It can go between 12 and 20 breaths per minute. Along the top is a gauge that measures the pressure inside the chamber. Next to it would have been an alarm where a light would go off if the pressure inside the chamber goes below a certain level. In case of electrical failure, there's a handle at the rear of the machine for manual operation. Along the side are ports for nurses to access the patient and windows. At the head of the machine is the collar that fits snugly around the patient's neck. This would have been made out of a sponge material or a plastic. There are also knobs to adjust the bed position inside, and a mirror so the patient can see what's going on in the world around them. This could also be a book rest, although somebody else would have to turn the pages. If a patient were in the iron lung for polio, they would be in there for about 2 to 3 weeks until they got well enough to breathe again on their own. So there you have it, the iron lung. Join us next time for a tour of the wooden X-ray machine.